Alright, hi guys! Welcome back to my channel. Today, I have my best friend, Sharmika, also known as Keisha, going to do this video with me. And we're going to talk about pregnancy symptoms.
Oh, wow. That's a surprise. You didn't tell me that.
What do you think it was about?
I don't know. You didn't even discuss that with me prior to making this video.
So, as you guys know, we all have different symptoms. Everybody goes through their own thing. And I wanted her to come and do this video with me because she had all the symptoms.
Yes.
We could share what we both had. So you mommies out there who are expecting or are trying to have babies. There's two mommies here. I just had a baby 4 months ago. So I'm a new time mom. And she has a 2-year-old. So she's more experienced and she's already, you know, a little bit farther than me with, you know, the whole baby thing. But we both experienced pregnancy. What would you say was your first sign of being pregnant, that you thought you were like, oh my God, I'm pregnant?
Well, my first sign was I had heartburn for one day, and I had what I call a fake cold, which was sneezing, a little sore throat, and that also lasts one day. And for some reason, I said, I think I'm pregnant. And I already knew at the time, once you're pregnant, your immune system suppresses. So the fact that I had this fake cold, I was something's not right. So that was pretty much it.
Were you late on your period? Because a lot of women out there, like, the first sign is, you know, you're late on your period.
Well, before I was late, I had the symptoms, and then I was 4 days late before I tested for my pregnancy.
My first sign, actually, I wasn't even late. My period wasn't supposed to come till, for example, the following week. But one day at work, I just felt so tired. Like, I've never felt that tired in my life. Like, I just couldn't concentrate. I was like, my mind wasn't there, my body wasn't there. I ended up leaving early that day from work and just coming home straight to sleep. And I think my first signs of pregnancy was that I was very tired. Victoria will join. So yeah, that was my first sign of pregnancy, and I tested the next day and I was pregnant. So that was it. And for the next couple of weeks, I would come home from work straight to sleep. I would just sleep.
But you did throw up sushi, remember?
Oh, no. Before I found out I was pregnant, that weekend before, I was craving sushi. And I was like, oh my God, I want sushi. I'm not a sushi like fan. Like, I will eat it, but I'm not like, oh my God, I have to have sushi. No. And I was craving sushi. So I went and got sushi. When I got home, I put a roll in my mouth and it made me nauseous. Like, I was like, oh my God, like, I can't eat it. And then I was like, I was forcing myself to eat it because I'm like, Carla, you were craving this. Like, you have to eat it. Mm-hmm. I put the second roll in my mouth and I had to spit it up. I was like, okay, that's weird. But I didn't think anything of it. But me being tired and my body feeling like that, that's when I was like, okay, maybe I'm pregnant. What other symptoms did you have?
I didn't have anything really until about 6 weeks or my 7th week. And it was the fatigue and the food aversions. My appetite changed completely. I think at the time I wanted to eat healthy. Oh, I'm pregnant, I want to eat clean, so I made a salad, and I did not like the taste of lettuce, tomatoes, nothing. I just ate the chicken.
She was so annoying.
I was a pregnant meat eater.
Oh my God.
A meat eater. And I think I had every symptom besides actually throwing up.
You didn't throw up?
No, I only threw up once. I think, or twice throughout my whole entire pregnancy.
Yeah, I think I got nauseous maybe less than 5 times. I think once in the car, I was really nauseous. Didn't throw up anything weird, like any weird cravings?
I didn't have weird cravings. I just didn't eat. I had a very suppressed appetite. I was nauseous every single day up until 4.5 months. So I had ear infection. I had my toothache. I had weird things, like all the weird.
She will listen, guys. This girl will call me, right? And sometimes I didn't want to pick up the phone because it will be like, oh, Keisha, my hip hurts, yes. My bones hurt. I was like,
I had symptoms that everybody didn't have. My symptoms were under the weird symptoms women have during pregnancy. And that's what I had. And I started feeling the sciatic nerve at 4 months. So imagine from 4 months to 9.5 months.
I think I had that, the sciatic nerve, like maybe when I was working, I would sometimes feel the shooting pain come up, but it wasn't like throughout, it was like once in a while I'll get it. What I really, my only pregnancy symptom that was the worst that
and
I
constant.
Was, and constant from 6 months I will say, or 5 months, I'm not sure, is my pelvic area. Guys, I felt like I had weights being strapped on my bones. And every time I would get up, it was like... and at work, it was... People would look at me like I was crazy. Because at work, I was like 6 months, okay? I would get up... Like, I would have to sit at my desk and think, do I really need to pee? Do I really need to get up? It got to the point that my coworkers were bringing me stuff from the printer. They were picking stuff up because I could not get up from my chair. I would get up and the pain was so bad that I would walk like this to the bathroom. Like, and I would stop and people were like, oh my God, what's wrong? And I'm like, I just have really bad pain, you know? And you know why? Now I know why. Because this little girl was 9 pounds. Yes, 9 pounds, guys. Yeah, so I think that's what caused it, that she was so heavy. That, and I'm like 5'3", so I'm not that tall. I think that all that pressure, that was my worst symptom.
I think you carried Victoria in the front, where me, I carried Liam in my back.
Yeah, I didn't have that much of back pain.
I had back pain. Horrible back pain. I had migraines. Yeah, I had migraines. It was rough.
I had migraines too. I think I had about 5 migraines throughout my pregnancy, and that was like during the second trimester. I will have headaches every day, every day. And then at times it would turn to migraines where I couldn't, it was so intense. I remember one day I was here and it was a Saturday and I just turned everything off. I put an eye mask on. And I didn't want to hear anything, see anything. It was really bad. It felt, and it was towards the front that I would get those headaches. And I didn't want to take anything. I was so anti-medication. Mm-hmm. I did not take anything. I just took, I did a lot of essential oils, and that helped. But that was another symptom that was like really bad. Anything?
I can't think of anything else that I had.
Keisha, you had every symptom. Now
I had the toothache, I had the ear infection, the headaches, the back pain. I didn't have any acid reflux.
Oh. Uh-huh.
I had the acid reflux, I think probably one day towards the end of my pregnancy. That was pretty much it.
No. You know when I experienced heartburn towards the end of my pregnancy. When was the big hurricane that came?
Irma.
When Irma came, we lost power at my house. We didn't have no power. Thankfully, everything was fine. I remember that was the first time I had heartburn. I remember my job put me in a hotel because we didn't have light and I was super pregnant and it was too hot. And I remember waking up like at 3 a.m. with this pain. It felt like a truck had went down my throat and scraped my insides all the way to my stomach.
Oh,
it was so bad. I was like, oh my God, what is this? And I'm like, I've never experienced heartburn, never, ever. I took, what is it called? The little things?
I don't know.
They're acid things. Altoids. Tums. I will like take 2-3. And then what really helped, because I you know, I looked online, is to lay on your left side and elevate your head. That helped me a lot. But that night was the worst case of heartburn. Like, I walked around. I couldn't go to sleep. I was praying. I was like, Lord, please take away this pain, because it was such, it was horrible. That came towards the end of the pregnancy. Once I gave birth, it never came back again. Thank you, Lord. Hopefully it doesn't come back, but yeah.
Yeah, that was all my symptoms. I just caught and complained every day because I was pregnant.
Oh my God, I was when she was pregnant, me and her sister told her after, like, she was still pregnant, but we kind of complained. We're like you complain too much. We don't want to pick up the phone. Like, you are off the chain. And then when I got pregnant, I was like, crap, now I can't complain. After she complained all the time, I was like, I can't call her and complain. I mean, I think I had a really good pregnancy. I didn't suffer a lot. Only the pelvic pressure and pain was the, you know, something that really bothered me. What else? What did we leave off?
I think we covered everything.
Oh no.
What?
Zebra stripes.
Oh yes, the stress. Well, that's not a symptom, but that's just the process.
Let me tell you. When I was pregnant, I researched everything. I looked at videos about pregnancy symptoms, what to watch out for. Never heard of this, okay? Never.
Oh, yes. Oh, that. I thought you were talking about the stretch marks.
No, well, the stretch marks, it's something that you're not... Let me tell you guys. You guys could put a whole bunch of oil, because I did it all, every day. Oil. My stretch marks didn't come in till like 2 or 3 weeks before I gave birth. Didn't have no stretch marks. I was like, oh, yes, thank you, Jesus. Nope. And then they came.
Well, mine started, I think early on. I started with the boobs.
Oh, well, yeah.
And then during my maternity pictures, I thought I was in the clear. I was excited. I said, no stretch marks. Because I could only see the top half of my stomach.
That's what happened, yeah.
And everyone's looking at me like, did you look at the bottom? And it was all in the bottom. The tiger stripes were in the bottom. My thighs, my hips, my butt. It's done. It's done.
Yeah, I think that's when I noticed that I had stretch marks, when I went to the doctor. And you know, you can't see your belly. But when I was at the doctor and I was laying down, and you know, the doctor's lights are very bright, my husband's like, oh my God, you could see the stretch marks. And the ones that I have are like the clear ones. So they're not like the black or red ones. So you couldn't really see it, even if I try to look. It was like kind of like those shiny ones. All right, guys, Victoria's back in action. If you guys didn't hear her, she's trying to make an appearance. Yes. So... Yeah, guys, so you guys could try oil, you could try lotions, but if your skin is meant to have stretch marks, it's going to happen. Yep. You know, what I could say is just drink a lot of water, which I didn't during my pregnancy. That helps too with your, you know, with your skin and
keeping it hydrated.
Yeah, so water, you could try the oils, the lotions, and see if that works, but
it doesn't work. My doctor actually told me, don't even waste my money. Especially if you're already prone to having stretch marks already, you're gonna have stretch marks. So
yeah, I had stretch marks already a little bit on my hip area.
Yeah, so did I. So. I had stretch marks on my thighs prior to being pregnant. So I already knew it was a done deal once I got pregnant. So I think that's pretty much it with the symptoms.
Well, my one symptom, like I stated, like I searched everything and I never saw this, was one day I was already towards the end of my pregnancy. It must have been like 7 or 8 months already. And I was in the kitchen and I was wearing shorts. And my husband, you know, I was preparing something and my husband comes from behind and he's like, oh my God, what happened to your legs? You have marks. And I'm like, marks? And he's like, yeah. He's like, and I'm thinking, oh man, maybe I was, you know, the leggings that I had probably were too tight or something. I'm like, maybe that's what it was. And he's like, yeah, but they're so like symmetrical. Like, how did that happen? So I'm like, I go look in the mirror and guys, it was not the pants, it was not a mark, it was my skin. Yeah. Discoloration of your legs, but it's so perfect. Like, it's like this.
Well, it's not only on the legs, because my arm, I don't know if you guys noticed.
Yeah.
Up here, yeah. I think it's a little darker, and it's lighter here. So, yeah, you get it on your arms also. And mine's never went away.
Strike four. Take four.
Strike.
So, yeah, so I was like, so I immediately researched the, you know, lines on your legs during pregnancy. And apparently it's not a common thing, but it does happen. It's just from what I read, I don't know the name of it, but from what I read, it's your hormones all over the place. It usually happens more to African-American and Hispanics, like dark-skinned people. And I was just like, oh my God, is this gonna go away? Because on you, when I told her what happened, she's like, oh yeah, I have it too. And I'm like, you never told me.
I forgot. I mean, the back pain, the sciatic, it wasn't important. So mine, like I said, is still there. It lightened up, but never went away.
Yeah, yours you can barely tell. I mean, you could tell a little bit, but not. Like me, if I wear a skirt,
yeah,
people are going to look at me like, what the heck happened to your legs?
Yeah, it was really bad. It's really bad.
But now it's going away. Mm-hmm. It's little by little, it's getting lighter. And even the texture of your skin, yeah, where it's darker, it feels rougher.
Yeah.
So that's one. And when I went to my doctor, I'm like, oh my God, can you look at my legs? Like, what the heck is this? And she's like, oh my God, I've only seen like 2 or 3 people with this.
Wow.
So it's not a common thing, guys. So don't get scared. Pray about it before you get pregnant. I prayed about everything. And the things that I didn't pray about is mostly what I got.
I think that's the same thing too. I got the unknown, like I said, the weird pregnancy symptoms. And of course the pigmentation, the most African-American women have it, the dark neck, the under the armpit.
Me too. I had it under my arms. I still have a little bit. But that's another thing. I was like, oh my God, this is so horrible. My doctor was like, girl, you're glad that you're getting this places that you could hide it, because a lot of women get it in their face.
Yes.
And that sometimes doesn't even go away. So, yeah. It's
the dark?
Yeah, on your skin. Oh, they said they get like a butterfly effect on their skin, like a dark thing. And a lot of women, it doesn't go away. So imagine.
Yeah.
So thankfully, I just had it under my armpits, and yeah, so it wasn't that bad. But other than that, then the usual stretch marks, you know, heartburn, headaches. The only unusual ones for me was the pelvic area pressure. And for that, what helped me a lot was the Epsom salt bath. Like, I will do baths with Epsom salt, and that really relieved the pain. It was so bad, guys, that sometimes I would put ice. That's how bad it was. So that's the only thing that was really bad.
But overall, we'll do it again.
Yeah, we'll do it again.
We prayed so hard for our babies, and
yes,
we will wear the stripes, the heartburn, the pelvic, the sciatic.
I'll do it
all
again.
All over again.
I'll do it again.
Because we have our blessings. And so in the comment, share some of your symptoms.
Yes, we would like to know, or what did he do to relieve them?
Yes.
Like I said, every woman has their own symptoms. Some don't even experience anything,
yes,
and some experience everything.
Everything. Everything.
But,
besides throwing up, which I'll take that again.
The throwing up.
Minus the ear infection.
Yeah, I think that was the worst thing, is the throwing up. I'm going to do another video on Victoria's birth story, which was so...
so magical.
Yeah. Keisha, if you would have stayed, you would have experienced it with me.
It was so magical. It was.
But yeah, I'll share with you guys in another video. This video, I just wanted you come together as mommies and share with you guys what we went through pregnancy, and how, you know, we're both moms. We experienced a lot of different things and a lot of the same things. But at the end of the day, you look at your child and, man, the stretch marks on my stomach. I mean, yeah, they're there. There's something that I did not want, but I look at my baby and it's like, man,
it's so
I don't care.
It.
Yeah, it's so worth it. It's,
yeah.
I would do it again. And so, yeah. So thank you guys for watching this video. If you guys haven't already, please subscribe and please put the like button on the video if you like this video. And let us know what you guys went through, or if you have any questions we could answer. You know, if you're a first-time mom or you're expecting and have any questions or have any other symptoms that we had and would like to know what we did to relieve them, let us know and we'll gladly answer your question. So until next time, bye.